Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and in today's video, allow me to talk about feeling judging and feeling perceiving, harmony and authenticity. What is love? Baby, don't hurt me.
Don't hurt me. No more. I find as a feeling judging or a feeling perceiving type, you're concerned with how you manage yourself and other people. How do I conduct and express myself as an individual, as a person? What do I do? How do I contribute towards my community? How do I help out to my family? What do I do for the people I love? How do I show care and kindness towards other people? How can I be authentic in representing my own needs and what I want to be happy? How can I find harmony between what I want and what other people want? And sometimes we are led to assume that the other types are less authentic, more manipulative, more selfish, or more self-centered than we are.
Truth is, feeling is, as a function, always striving towards greater harmony, greater authenticity, greater truthfulness in how you live, how you see yourself, and how you conduct yourself as a person. Typically, feeling judging can best be described metaphorically as a warming campfire that invites you to set yourself down and rest and share your stories. Where feeling perceiving is, in many ways, like a form of mirror that reflects and authenticates and gives judgment on what is good, what is beautiful, what is ugly, what is real, what is fake. There is a territorialness to being a feeling and judging type in the sense that you claim a social space. You set up and create a social environment around you. As a feeling judging type, you naturally feel responsible for the people, for the community, and for the group, and for the social space that you all share. The feeling perceiving type is individualistic and person-oriented, but the feeling judging type is group and social space-oriented. This means that typically feeling judging types tend to bring people together in a circle or in a square or in a space, creating a form of shared identity, temporary or long-term. Making every person, every animal, every part, every component of the environment relate to one another. Centrally, what drives a feeling judging type is a desire for social and moral coherence. Each individual person's ethics and values and beliefs should line up with the other people's beliefs and morals. Everyone doesn't have to think or feel the same way, but everyone's values have to align and be understood as a system. People's individual values and opinions should not collide with or cause conflict between one another. But differing values should be able to exist in harmony with one another, allowing each person the right to self-expression without taking away from other people's right to self-expression. Where feeling perceiving typically portrays itself as the strong individual that says, "This is me, this is what I represent, this is what I believe in." Feeling and judging is the person that says, "This is what we should believe in as a group, as a community." The feeling perceiving type starts in the own self-representation, where the feeling judging type starts in the collective representation. Who are we as a people, as a community? What do we do? What do we stand for? And how do we represent that? The feeling judging type feels responsible for the group's collective expression and feels involved in what other people say and do. And so typically when the feeling perceiving type experiences conflict, what the feeling perceiving type will do is simply say, "Well, if we're not aligned, then I will leave." Where the feeling judging type will feel like there is something to settle, something to solve, something to align and bring together. Now, typically, when you use feeling judging or feeling perceiving, there is always something confronting about that. If you represent and stand up for your truth or for what you think is the collective truth, then you will attract conflict, you will attract discussion, debate, and social clashes and struggles. Simply by being who you are as a feeling perceiving type, your very existence will bring up debate if you dare to represent yourself bravely to the world. Simply by speaking out for the collective interests, you will spark debate and conflict in the group as a feeling judging type. This is just a natural part of the feeling process and of purifying and finding harmony and finding peace together with other people. When you live around other people, you have to expect struggles and conflict because everyone has a strong sense of identity and beliefs. That's what it means to be human. Now, the feeling perceiving type is no more or no less likely to stand up for or fight for their beliefs. What makes you want to stand up for and fight for your beliefs, that is a strong judging or a strong perceiving function, as well as a strong conscientiousness, a strong desire to do what is right, a strong desire to do things in a correct or right or truthful or authentic manner. Now, what can be really difficult as a feeling perceiving type is that awareness that people need you, people need your help, people need you to fix their issues and to solve their problems, and you care about them and you feel guilty about not doing it. But you also know that doing it, to do it, exposes you to such stress. In that sense, you feel this sense of ambivalence. You want to help other people, but it stresses you out so much to engage other people on that level, because it requires you to step out of yourself and your own shoes. And it is difficult for the feeling judging type to consider their own personal needs, because often they feel unimportant and even stressful to think about. What kind of tea do I want? What kind of favorite color on my dress do I like? Those smaller issues that often take the standpoint more in your individual character or subtle nuances are often missed as you're focused on the more broad values and the more overarching values that you live by. As a feeling judging type, you have this gut reaction to compromise on all the smaller things, just because you assume that they have no value to you, or just because you don't think it matters. But after a while, you can notice that all those smaller things add up to something quite big. And that is also when it's time to set your foot down and to make sure you can find some better flow, some better form of harmony and justice. And it is typically those on the green or the blue path that are going to have the strongest values on social and physical conduct, how you should live, how you should solve problems, and how you should express yourself. Now, it's not uncommon culturally to argue that feeling judging types have a weak moral compass, but we also have pictures of people like Martin Luther King standing up for and shouting out for what they think is right. How is this possible? When you initially hear the word harmony and you relate it to feeling judging, you assume it is something weak. But typically, it is something that spurs you to action. When a feeling type gets in touch with the feeling process, they get a stronger sense of what is right. What is the proper code of conduct? What is the proper way to treat other humans? What is the right or wrong way to do something? And when you get in touch with this process, with feeling as a feeling type, you have to act on it. You have to represent what you have learned is right or wrong. And so I would argue that the feeling judging type has a different starting point in finding harmony, in finding what is right and wrong. The feeling judging type starts with, what does the community think? What does the people think? But gradually, as they get to know the people better, they start noticing that each individual in this harmony, each person, each part in this collective, and how everyone is unique and every person has a different story, but how it all fits together connects to the keyword harmony. The feeling judging type starts their process of getting to know their values and their beliefs by getting to know the people around them. Where the feeling perceiving type starts with the individual person, the you in you. And in what you say, and every single thing you say, every small nuance in how you express yourself, in what you do, in how you act, and what decisions you make, and how each word fits with you and your sense of right and wrong, your harmony. As a feeling perceiving type, you are compassing. You are constantly checking everything you do against your compass. Was that right? Was that right? Was that right? Did that connect? Did that connect? Did that connect? And as you do, you gradually get a stronger sense of identity, a stronger sense of who you are. And you do the same as you mature. You start paying attention and directing this compass also towards other people in your vicinity. You start broadening your compass until you include more and more people, until you get a stronger sense of kinship and connection to the greater whole. Now, feeling perceiving types are the authenticators. They authenticate and decide if something is real or if it's not. And the interesting thing about both feeling perceiving and feeling judging is its role in advancing your character and your beliefs and in getting power in your community. Feeling perceiving and feeling judging are empowering functions. Feeling judging makes people around you listen to you. It makes and aligns everyone around you to you. It wraps and connects you to the greater group. It gives you power over other people's decisions, over how other people live out and conduct themselves throughout their life. You get power as a motivator. And that is a power that requires quite a great deal of responsibility. And the same goes for feeling perceiving, in the sense that as a feeling perceiving type, if you develop this function, you're going to notice that it gives you a tremendous amount of power. Power over fundamentally deciding what is right and wrong. Power to decide what is authentic, what is right in each group, in each system, in each social environment. Typically, when we look to the feeling perceiving types, it is as judges of eventually who has committed a crime and who has not, who is guilty and who is not. And that is why feeling perceiving can also be a quite dangerous power. When you're studying feeling perceiving as an empowerment function, it is like studying the power of the individual, the power of the person that stands up and says what they believe in, regardless of what anyone else thinks, the person that stands up and says no, the person that walks away when the group doesn't align, the person that fundamentally becomes the judge of who is a criminal, who is a good person, and who is a bad person. It is to the feeling perceiving types we look when we look for authentic judgment of right and wrong. Real judgment of when things are right and when things are wrong. And the feeling perceiving type has a tremendous power in shaping social groups, shaping societies, simply by refusing to go along with social cohesion from other people. And yeah, in that sense, feeling perceiving is both admirable and terrifying. A question such as, why is that man naked, can be potentially dangerous, as we see in the Emperor's New Clothes. An interesting thing I've noticed about the people with strong feeling judging as a superpower, with strong feeling perceiving as a superpower,
is that most of these people, most of these famous public speakers, most of these influential figures have experienced strong, great, difficult trauma and tragedy. It is typically when you've experienced tragedy that you need storytelling the most. That's when you need to start wondering about who you are as a person, where you're headed in life, and what your overarching purpose is. What puts you the most in tune with feeling perceiving and feeling judging is to be on the green path in life, to be on the path to power, to be on the path away from trauma and from tragedy, towards changing and making an impact on the world, making a difference for yourself and for other people around you. And that is interesting because feeling is traditionally helping others, being kind, being a good person, restoring justice, healing wounds, dealing with trauma, solving issues, solving conflicts, creating peace. But at the same time, the study of feeling is the study of manipulation and control and people hurting each other and conflicts and violent struggles in society. It is just as much about power as thinking is. Feeling is both a tool to harm the world and to make the world a better place. Feeling is neither good nor bad. And I find it is not so much about being a feeler as in being healthy and being a feeler. Being authentic in your self-expression as a feeler. Being mindful of yourself and of other people as a feeler. Caring about yourself as well as other people. Showing kindness just as much to other people as to yourself. You can find authenticity as a feeling judging type as long as you are mindful of how it all adds up. How does everything you do add up to who you are, to what you need to be happy? How does the people you date, the people you love, the people you care about, your family members, and you, yourself as a person, fit together? How can you be yourself around these people without hurting them? How can these people be around you and to be themselves without hurting you? Feeling and judging is about setting a boundary, telling other people what you need to be happy, telling other people what you all need to have harmony, and that includes yourself. I hope this video made you understand feeling judging and feeling perceiving better. They are two different processes, all aiming to the same value, towards harmony, kindness, benevolence, peace, understanding, wisdom, and harmony in all ways. But they start differently, and they only meet in the middle.